Sixth graders, this is to help you with question three on CR25. Which statement is correct? So first of all, I guess all of these are all greater than. This says is greater than. If you're going to compare decimals, you should compare place value. Over letter A, if I'm comparing decimals, I'll compare place values. So if I look at this, I know I have my ones place, decimal point, then my tenths place. So I have 1.4 that I'm comparing and 1.6. Well, they match in the ones place. And then if I look here, 4 is smaller than 6. So 1.6 is greater than 1.4. So this one's false. Sometimes with decimals, I also like to think about it in terms of money. I could put a 0 after that. So that would be $1.60 is definitely greater than $1.40. Let's talk about B. To compare fractions, you need to find a common denominator. Once you find a common denominator, you can just compare their numerators. But first you have to rewrite them as equivalent fractions with a common denominator. So if I have 4/5 and I have 3/4, I'm going to rewrite each of those with a common denominator of 20. How do I get from 5 to 20? I multiply by 4. So if I'm multiplying the denominator by 4, I need to multiply the numerator by 4. So that is 16/20. Here, I'll multiply 4 by 5 to get to 20. If I'm multiplying the denominator by 5, I need to multiply the numerator by 5. 3 times 5 is 15. Ooh, that's kind of nice. 4/5 says is greater than 3/4. So as soon as I found my common denominator, this is 16/20 is greater than 15/20. Once they have a common denominator, I can just compare the numerators. 16 is greater than 15. So this is a true statement. Negative 1.6 is not greater than negative 1.4. If I'm on a number line, this is 0. I'm going to just say negative 0.2, negative 0.4, negative 0.6, negative 0.8, negative 1.0. This right here would be negative 1.2. This right here would be negative 1.4. This would be negative 1.6. Then you'd have negative 1.8 and then negative 2. Negative 1.6 is definitely smaller than negative 1.4. That's false. And then I could show the last one. We could show a common denominator, and I could prove that that was false too. But I already figured out that B was true, so hopefully that helps.